respect the dignitaries of all faiths. Venerable Professor Agamaha Pandita Kumburgame Vajra Nayaka Theru, co-chair of the forum. Mr. M.H. Mohammed, one-time speaker, one-time minister, a co-chair also of the forum. Our distinguished chief guests, Mr. Veerutunga, Secretary to Excellency the President, Honorable Minister, Mr. Vasudeva Nanakkara, Your Excellency, the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. May I first wish you Aibuang, Vanakkam, Assalamu Alaikum, and of course, good evening all round. May I first begin by thanking the forum, giving the pleasure and the privilege of addressing you, addressing this distinguished audience on this very auspicious and felicitous occasion. I am also delighted by the presence of the Secretary to Excellency the President. You, sir, in regard to the pivotal position you hold, are virtually the keeper of the nation's conscience. It is appropriate and most fitting that you should be here to grace this occasion today. I am obliged, of course, to the forum for permitting me to make this address. I express my gratitude to the co-chairs and the fellow members of the forum. In the first instance, may I propose the ideological context, the birth of the forum, and the source and the origin of the declaration. Of course, the word ideological context is a nice word, is familiar to my former friend to the left, but I shall seek to place our activities in historical perspective. May I take you back to May 2009. The brutal war, the separatist war, had ended. The nation was engulfed in euphoria, sighing a sigh of relief. But to the credit of His Excellency the President, he did not exult in victory. He specifically said that it was not a victory of any community, it was only a defeat of terrorism. Now that firmly set the course for national reconciliation. More was to follow. He articulated the concept, which is a part of the theme today, one nation, one people, when he said, there are no majority community in this country, there are no minorities, we are all Sri Lankans. So there were heady days. We were all seeking and groping for a Sri Lankan identity, for a Sri Lankan consciousness. We were engaging in the debates. These thoughts resonated with our co-chairs, the distinguished venerable professor and Mr. Amity Mohammed. They gave us leadership, and thus was born the Forum for National Amity. In the course of our deliberations, it dawned on us, of course, the realization came that we are the heirs to the four great traditions of the world, the four great religions of the world. We said to ourselves that distilled wisdom in the religions, the teachings, the synthesis formed a background, a framework for the restoration of national unity in this country, and so came the declaration being released today. It represents the distilled wisdom, the distilled teachings of two great teachers of humanity, Lord Buddha and the Holy Prophet. Of course, one would say that mere platitudes and declarations are not enough. We have to ask ourselves the questions, how far have we fallen short of these ideals? How do we take these ideas forward? Now here I wish to say that the ideas I venture to express now, the opinions I venture to express, are entirely mine. They do not necessarily represent the views of the forum. And I am thankful to the forum for giving me the license and the privilege of articulating my own thoughts. Of course, a commitment at the highest level, at all levels, is essential to take us forward. The unfortunate events of Alutgama was certainly a setback to the wisdom and the vision of His Excellency the President, articulated in the concept of one nation, one people. There are gnawing questions that arise. We have in our statute book laws against hate speech. They have been here from the time of the British, in the Penal Code and the Criminal Procedure Code, from time of the British regime itself. His Excellency the President's government fine-tuned this. And we have the ICCPR in 2006, enacted in legislation in Sri Lanka, specifically banning hate speech and providing very severe punishment for hate speech. So ask myself the question, had the law been enforced effectively, had effective preemptive action been taken, would the events of Alutgama have taken place? The point I am making is that this vision of His Excellency should percolate downwards and reach those who execute the law, who carry his vision into effect in practical terms. We all know about the sectarian marches in Northern Ireland, the problems that arose. If the police had a nodding acquaintance with sectarian marches in Ireland, would they have permitted that fatal march in Alutgama? I am sorry to say, these are troubling questions to which we need the answers. It may not be polite to strike a discordant note on occasion like this, but as I said, Mr. Secretary, you are the key for the nation's conscience, and the bitterness endangered by the Alutgama events should percolate to the government.
The Value-Based Media Network.